Welcome back to my channel, guys, and today we're going to talk about Fate Echo. So I'm going to be watching this and I'm going to tell you what I'm thinking originally and what I'll probably think afterwards and whether we're going to get it or not, because we're waiting for Evernight. It's not coming. I feel so snaked right now, but whatever, let's just dive into this. So, starts off with some really nice music and it's already in the sands. I'm thinking that it's in Wasteland, obviously for Wasteland reasons. And then we see a green area and teepees. Nice. Okay, that hair looks a little too real and I already like the hair because it's white and long. The makeup. That makeup, if you look underneath the whatever the tattoo is on her face, it's really this blush pink on her cheek area and there's blue eyeshadow around her eyes. And as for the tattoo itself, I don't really like it. It looks kind of meh. I like the one where we got from the mountain hell event more than this one because this one just looks a little weird for my taste. And I already have something similar to this, but I'm digging the hair. Not really digging her dress, not really digging the feathers. This color scheme we've seen so many times, especially during that one month where we kept having dark things, like the dark poem, and we had the dark wedding dress, and yeah, I don't know. This is like the same thing as a dark wedding dress with the very dark maroon and the black and some blackish blue aspects, but doesn't look like a typical Wasteland outfit, if it's a Wasteland outfit to begin with. We already have quite a few closing eye makeup, so I'm assuming that I could just replace any one of those sleeping eyes that I have with this one, and it would still look the same under the tattoo she has. I'm like, okay, not feeling it that much. And the hair moving, it's a joke because it's probably not animated as usual, so I'm just gonna ignore that altogether. And we see a little sandstorm coming about. Crap. Here is when they summon my soul and ask me for my entire life savings. They can't just give me this mediocre outfit with great hair and then put some magical like Rune Kingdom items and expect me to buy it, because I will buy it. And here we go. We have our second outfit, which is even more ridiculous because just from the cloth material I see from the bottom of her dress, I already know I like her. And boom, we love her because her eyes, I wanted Jingle Kitty for ages and I couldn't get her because she's so expensive and I'm not gonna be dumping like $10 to $15 on that thing. I like her a lot. I think saying I like her is an understatement. I'm not even trying to hype her up because you guys know me. If there's an outfit that's ugly, I will roast it, or I would just like tell you guys how much I don't like it. So that's pretty much it. I am really upset because I was hoping for an ugly event where I can just take a break and let my diamonds just be happy. And Evernight is still looming over our heads, so it kind of sucks because you're just like, shit, should I save up for Evernight or should I spend all my diamonds on this one? And I heard from Reddit that this is going to be a currency item so we can finally freaking pick and choose. I am so sick of not being able to pick one outfit over the other. And for this event, because we can pick and choose, I think I am going to go for the second one. So the best thing about it being a pick and choose event is that you can choose which outfit you want. But a lot of the times, it's like, do you really need to complete an outfit? That's the most important part about this game. This game, it rewards you for completing prizes by increasing your percentage and then increasing your wardrobe stuff and then giving you like a shitty completion prize of 30 diamonds. That's honestly nothing. I just want you guys to just think about it right now. Like, this one is just really enticing because the makeup is already just blowing my mind. A lot of people already love it off the bat. But I just want you guys to just think before participating fully in this event, because when the hell event comes and you aren't prepared for it, would you be upset about that? Like, what I do for these specific events is that I don't complete either suits, but I get the best items from each suit. Because the thing about completing an outfit is that, yes, it's great to have it in your wardrobe and you can just put it on and have the stupid pose, whatever. But the worst part about completing an outfit is that you have to spend diamonds on stupid accessories. You might have to buy socks that might not even be seen in the actual outfit, or a necklace item slash choker item that you already have 10 similar ones of. Do you need to buy the entire outfit? Because if not, then you can just save a lot of stress and diamonds by just buying the things you want. For example, I always go for the two makeups and whatever tattoo item they have. And that usually gets covered by all the free tries. If I feel like I really, really love something, like the foreground item, for instance, or the hourglass, then maybe I'd just see if it's worth me getting. At the end of the day, all of these will come back for crafting and you can spend diamonds then, or you might not even like it after a while. Once the hype kind of dies down, then you realize you don't really like it at all. In instead of spending 4,000 diamonds on both suits and then having wasted diamonds on items you didn't really want in the first place, you get most of the items you want, because what's the point in getting all these items when you won't even be using them at all? That's what I found by playing a lot of Love Nikki. Once I finished the suits, I never really use them as a pair. I use specific items from every part of the suit to make a different suit. The fun thing about Love Nikki is that you can craft your own outfit, and that's the most important part. You're not going to be using every single part of the thing. But like this is just for the people who don't really have many options, like they can't buy anything or they want to be V0. For those of you who can spend all your diamonds on both outfits, go ahead. Like, I'm not shaming you guys at all. This is just advice for people like me who don't want to spend a lot of diamonds on this game, who don't want to spend a lot of money on this game and would like to preserve as many diamonds as possible, but still enjoy the game to a certain degree. So I hope this was helpful, and I hope that I'm not annoying with all the advice about how to save your diamonds, but I thought that sometimes like it's nice to have that nagging voice at the back of your head so that you don't feel guilty about purchasing stuff you don't really want in the first place. So yeah, if you like more content like this, please like and subscribe and hit that bell, because I will be doing the full tutorial when this event comes out. So thank you guys for watching, and I hope you guys have a great day. Bye!